Lifestyle will change. Now I am going to be talking a little bit about the allopathic treatment, so you understand how I have brought together my acupressure, my alternate medicines, and the allopathic treatments together. Now, once you are diagnosed, your doctor will take out a big long. I work in the Tata Memorial. Most of you know about it. So I hate those files with the person's name, Mrs. or Mr. So and so. And nowadays, kids, infants, little tiny, tiny kids come to me. They are suffering from cancer. It's a number that is given to them. Okay? So once you are being diagnosed, then you are either put on to sessions of chemotherapy or radiation. Okay? And the first step is biopsy. Now, since I'm working in a government hospital, I cannot talk to them about my treatment, which I don't. But once the hospital declares them palliative, which means no further treatment, no medicines, no nothing, like we were talking about, it's very scary when you have to wait for your death. And that is the time the patients are sent to me. By God's grace, many of them have recovered. They are survivors of cancer. Many of them I have lost. But the people that I have lost have taught me things. Like Durish was just telling me, she gave me a number that Lydia was telling you about. She called me and she said, I cannot come for your lecture. But like my daughters tell me that God had to make you, because otherwise, you know, she called me and it disturbed me so much that it's raining very heavily and there are floods all over and my children were not ready to let me get out of the house unless I take a male cab. I said, okay, done. And what convinced me to pay that 700 rupees to come here was that lady's call. And I promised her, I told her as a doctor, I spoke to her all the medical jargon that we followed and I put the phone down. But I could not have my breakfast, I was not concentrating, so my daughter came to me and she said, please forgive us, but call that lady and tell her as soon as the rain stops, you will go to her house and pray. So I called her and you won't believe it, I'm feeling so nice that I did call her, because as soon as I told her that I will come to you, if you want I will come today immediately after I finish my lecture, she said that over there. Or after the rains. She said, I don't know what my timing is. Meaning, I don't know whether by evening or tomorrow or day after I will be there. But I will want to meet you after the rains. Because today is a very bad day for her. She's in too much of pain. So I've asked her what she's supposed to take, which is very much in your kitchen. You do a lot of cooking. Right? So it is in your kitchen, it lowers the pain factor in the body. Now, chemotherapy is something that literally kills you. People that are taking chemotherapy, if you see them, you will find that they are half their size. They become very irritable. Everything about the body changes. The person who was so boisterous and so naughty suddenly has become very irritating, very rude. But if you know that the person is suffering from cancer, please do not take offense at what the person is going through. What I have done is that even in the Tata Memorial or even in my acupressure center or my house at Mira Road, I sit and talk to the person. I am not God, nor are you God. I cannot say I will cure you and you will not die. So we should work hand to hand. So I am doing that as a counselor at the Tata. I sit with them and I tell them, okay, now they've asked you to start your cycle of maybe 6 or 4 or 10 or 12 sessions of chemotherapy. What you should do is increase the immunity of your body before you go into the chemotherapy world. Because what does chemotherapy do? It kills the immunity in the body. So, if you first increase